It was a very quiet morning in the garden, and Slowcoach was enjoying the peace and stillness. Ah, there's nothing like a nice quiet morning's read of a good book.
Wah! Oh, it's raining carrots! All right, you two. I said all right, you two. What's going on this time?
Bill and Ben explained they were playing hunt the carrot. One of them throws the carrot as far as he can. Then they see which of them can get to it first.
Keep it down! Oh, look at the mess they've made. Hooligans!
Ben had got to the carrot first, so now it was his turn to throw it.
Hey, you two, what about my house? Come back and...
Whimsy was having a quiet morning snooze when she was woken by a flying carrot.
What happened? Ooh, it's really smelly in here.
Flubber number one.
As Ben got ready to throw the carrot again, he didn't notice that he was caught on Gnome's fishing line. Bill thought this was very funny. Ben didn't.
Yeah, flubber number put it back in the flubber.
Ben thought that Bill had something to do with it. Bill said that he hadn't. And anyway, Ben was a hopeless carrot thrower in any case.
Oh, flubber the flubber. Flubber the gonna flubber.
Yeah, flubber. Flubber the little poo.
Flubber the little flubber. Flubber the little poo. The
I've got a ball to pick with you two. Have you seen the state of my house? No, of course you haven't. You've been too busy making noise and nuisance. You've got some tidy up to do, you have. Now come along and no more of your nonsense.
Bill and Ben had almost finished tidying up the mess they'd made in Slowcoach's house. But they were still cross with each other.
Come along, you two. Less of the argufying, more of the tidying, if you don't mind.
Flubber done it.
Flubber full it.
I suppose that'll do. Now I'll be off with you. And no more larking about in my house.
Bill and Ben had never been so grumpy with each other before.
Hello, you two. Finished playing your game?
Flub.
Flub.
Are you all right? You've not fallen out, have you? Boys! That's enough. Oh, dear.
The garden was quiet. Very quiet indeed, and soon everyone began to wonder why.
Ah, peace at last.
Pry decided to ask Weed if she knew anything about it.
It's Bill and Ben. They've fallen out, and they're very, very grumpy.
Perhaps we'd better try to cheer them up.
Flubber.
Flop! Excuse me. Couldn't help overhearing. Bit down in the dumps, aren't we? Well, when I'm down in the dumps, I always find a game of sniff cheers me up. Do you want to play?
Flubber.
See, how you play is like this. You have a really good sniff, and the person who smells the most interesting smell is the winner. Are you ready? One, two, three. Ah! Compost. I can smell compost. How about you? No? Not playing, eh? Well, suit yourselves. I'll just have to play on my own. Oh, compost. Again.
Scamper arrived to see if she could cheer Bill and Ben up.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. Pry told me you were a bit down in the dumps, so... Oh, well, all the more for me.
Pry arrived with a shiny thing.
Look what I've found.
She hopes it might cheer them up. But it didn't.
Well, I like it.
Even Tad had heard about how fed up Bill and Ben were. He came along to tell them some jokes.
Here, I'll tell you what. Right, I went to the doctor's yesterday. I says, here, doctor, I think I'm a pair of curtains. He says, well, pull yourself together. Yeah. Right. All right, then, how about this one? I went down to the doctor's. I got a banana in one ear, cucumber in the other, and a carrot up my nose. Doctor, I says, what's wrong with me? He says, you're not eating properly. Yeah. Right. How about this one? I says, doctor, I keep thinking I'm a dog. He says, get up on the couch then. So I says, I can't. I'm not allowed on the couch. Not allowed! You see, the doctor says, because there was a dog, you see, in the couch. You can't get on there because the dog's not allowed on the couch. Oh, why?
Bill and Ben decided to go and sulk somewhere where people wouldn't try to cheer them up.
Yeah, compost.
Though Bill and Ben were both in a really bad mood, Slowcoach was feeling very happy indeed. Peace and quiet. You can't beat a bit of peace and quiet.
I don't know. Bill and Ben are really grumpy. I can't understand it.
Don't knock it, Tad. Oh, don't knock it, my boy. The longer they stay grumpy, the longer the garden will be all lovely and peaceful and quiet. Oh, lovely.
Yeah, compost.
Slowcoach was enjoying the day so much.
Oh, I'd raise my hat to you, but I haven't got a hat.
He thought he'd go for a little walk in the peaceful garden.
Coach.
Just my little joke, Weed. Just my little joke. Oh, it's nice to see those two nuisances being so quiet for...
Poor Slowcoach hadn't seen the carrot, but Bill and Ben had seen Slowcoach falling over.
What? Help! No! Oh, no! Hooligans!
Bill and Ben had almost forgotten how good it is to laugh. And how, when you're laughing, you can't stay cross with anyone for long.
Well, don't stand there giggling like a couple of hysterical hyenas. Do something.
Well, aren't you going to say thank you?
Flob?
Flobber?
To Slowcoach. After all, he's the one who cheered you up, isn't he?
Flobber dag, Slobber love. So they did. And they promised never to fall out with one another ever again.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
Where are the Teletubbies?
Can
you see the tweenies? What about the play days, boss? Where can they all be? In the garden? In the house? Or hiding up a tree? You'll find them weekdays after 9 here on CBBC.
Boo!
Boo!
Keep watching CBBC because Fireman Sam is coming up next. But before that, it's time to do our morning stretches. Yes, let's see, wiggle those fingers and let's see you stretching up to the sky as high as you possibly can. That's it. Stretch those fingers nice and big, round in a big circle, and go back up again. Let's see you wiggle them. Now, let's have a look at someone doing their morning stretches. This is a picture of Jack Hartwell, who is 4 years old. He does his morning stretch every morning. Well done, Jack, and well done to everyone who does their morning stretches. What's that? Is that a fire engine? It must be time for Fireman Sam.